is Moosa Moghimi, and I'm a postdoctoral fellow at the Sustainable Computing Research Group at the Computing Science Department of the University of Alberta. Today, I'm going to talk about our research on voltage regulation techniques in modern distribution systems. With growing concerns about global warming, we are seeing many new technologies being installed in the distribution systems, from smart meters and other measurement devices to renewable energy sources like rooftop photovoltaic installations, or to new electrical loads like electric vehicles, which all contribute to reducing fossil fuel consumption. To take advantage of all of these technologies and at the same time ensure safe and secure operation of the electrical grid, we need to have proper controls in place. And proper control starts with proper monitoring, which is why we started our research with studying different state estimation techniques that enable proper monitoring and control of the distribution system. But there's more studies to do with all the benefits that come with PVs and electrical vehicles come a lot of challenges. For example, consider an electrical distribution system that has many PV installations. Ideally, we want the voltage level to always stay within certain limits that is safe for the consumers, the appliances, and for the grid equipment. But we see that around noon, we have some overvoltages, which is caused by the extra PV generation. Also, we see some voltage violations in the evening, and the voltage goes below the allowed limit here due to the increase in the electrical load demand and the decrease in the PV generation. I should add that having additional electrical loads like electric vehicles make this matters worse. And I also should mention that traditional distribution systems have some methods to deal with these voltage violations, but they are not simply enough to address all of the problems introduced by this PV and EVs. But that's not all the problem. All of the EV owners typically want to charge up their vehicle right after they get home in the evening. So many of these vehicles demand charge power at the evening hours at the same time. And I should mention that a single electric vehicle can drive power equivalent to several homes. So it's easy to see that such high demand can cause overloadings for transformers and transmission lines, and eventually can damage equipment. To solve this problem, we rely on scheduling the electric vehicle chargings using reinforcement learning techniques. And we try to efficiently use the maximum capacity of the grid without causing any voltage violation problems or any overloadings. At the same time, ensure that the maximum possible power is delivered to the electric vehicles. To deal with the voltage rise problems in the distribution system caused by the PV installations, we rely on energy storage units or batteries. So the idea is pretty simple. We want to charge up the batteries around noon when we have extra solar generation available. And in the evening, we can discharge these batteries and inject this extra power or extra stored energy back to the grid when the PV generation is at its minimum or is non-existent, but the load demand is at its peak. So in this way, we can fix the discrepancy between the solar generation and the electrical demand. Sample results show that we can effectively regulate the voltage using these distributed batteries. And I should mention that we want to have a method that is distributed and preserves the privacy of the consumers and scales well for larger systems with many PV installations.